coming home, I'm coming home. Tell the world I'm coming home. Let the rain wash away all the pain of yesterday. I know my kingdom awaits, and they've forgiven my mistakes. I'm coming home, I'm coming home. Tell the world I'm coming.
I'm coming home. Ladies and gentlemen, we are home. Yes, we are home. Final Fantasy 14. Bro, it's been so long since I have been on this damn game. And I also have it on PC. That's the crazy thing. So, you guys won't see it, probably. But it runs so much smoother and it's so livelier on PC. I think it's the extra frames. It has been months. It has been months since I've been on this damn game. Oh my god. Now look, I am back on controller, because that's what I've always played Final Fantasy on when I was on PlayStation. Eventually I'll learn how to play it on PC, but for right now, we have a mission. We have something to do. The newest patch, the story. Also, I have a boom arm. Your boy's getting professional. So hopefully, when it comes to least audio, you guys will be able to, you know, hear me better. It'll be much cleaner. A much cleaner sound. A much richer sound. You know, I finally got my mic off the damn table. So when I'm playing WoW, you know, I have a lot more movement in what I'm doing. So that's sweet. All right, now look, before I even do story, it doesn't matter what game I'm playing. Whether it's this, whether it's WoW. I always like to kind of warm up with a dungeon first, just to get myself reacclimated with the game. And plus, it's been so long since I've touched Final Fantasy. I really need to sharpen up my skills. So, let me do a quick dungeon run. You know what? Actually, I might keep this in a video, because I wanted to talk about something. Mainly the differences between WoW dungeons and Final Fantasy dungeons. Oh, also, this will be a level 90 dungeon, so spoilers. But look, so over in WoW, I've really been playing a lot more dungeons lately. And one thing I noticed, really, I mean, what the, whoa. Wait, what the fuck? No. Yeah, see, this is why I wanted to, reacclimate myself, jeez. Because it's been a minute since I played Warrior. Jesus Christ. But one thing that I noticed while playing, you know, a lot more WoW dungeons, is that, I don't know, it doesn't feel as, what's the right word? I want to say cozy as Final Fantasy dungeons. Now, I noticed that people don't really talk as much. Dude, what the fuck? Bro, a tank? I mean, the actual healer is pulling. Okay. Yo, homie is ready, bro. Homie is ready. I dig it. I feel it. I respect it. Holy shit. But one thing I appreciate always about playing Final Fantasy Dungeons is that when it comes down to it, like if we happen to wipe a couple of times, like there's no one really leaving the party. There's... Wait. The fuck? Did that sound was always there? That invalid target? I gotta see if I can remove that. Oh. I almost forgot how to even run this dungeon. And I have missed. I've honestly missed playing this game. It has been months. Months since I picked this damn thing up. I mean, but I've also been enjoying, you know, really diving into WoW and playing that and discovering, you know, what other MMOs can offer, you know? And I think that's one of the main, you know, one of the best things about playing other video games. Oh, shit. Another difference that I've also seen in, you know, Final Fantasy dungeons in WoW Dungeons is that WoW players, well, excuse me, Final Fantasy players, they're more acclimated to actually talk and have a conversation in game. Like, as you can, well, you can't see because my webcam is covering chat. But they're actually in here talking, they're speaking. Which makes it feel like a more chill environment, you know? I mean, usually in, well, I've noticed in most, you know, WoW dungeons that I've been in, there's no one really talking. Everyone's here just to, you know, do their thing and leave. I mean, which is cool, you know? You gotta respect people's time and all that. But I mean, it's, I don't know, it's just different. It doesn't really feel the same, you know? It doesn't really feel like you're engaging with, you know, the community when it's just, okay, let's just go in, do the thing, and then everyone just go their own separate ways. Bro, the healer is, bro, you gotta respect the healer, man. The healer's going for it. Yeah. Now see, when I used to be a dick, when I first started playing this game, I mean, I still am, but I would just let the mobs just like beat the fuck out of the healer, like, and it used to be hilarious. I mean, and sometimes when people are pulling like ahead of me, I mean, now that I got a very firm grasp on how to tank, at least in Final Fantasy, like, it doesn't really bother me because I know, you know, at the end of the day I can handle it. And plus, this is a level 90 dungeon, so they expect you to kind of know how to play. I mean, and it also feels so strange being back on controller. Cause like, I'm getting like really kind of comfortable with mouse and keyboard. I mean, I'm still not as proficient as I am still on controller. But like, there is more of a learner, like kind of like a readjusting of the brain. Bro, I will say, man. Yo, the healer is going for it. Shadow, whoever this guy is, man, he is. Oh, there he goes. All right, that's rock. I thought he was gonna try to pull everything and then like wait for me to spawn in. I mean, but that is good that he has that level of trust, you know, in me. Shit, I missed one. I missed one. I missed one. I missed one. Crap, pull him towards me, bro. Pull him towards me. There we go. There we go. There we go. Yo, the healer's going for it, bro. The healer's going for it. Bro, I respect his bravery. I respect his bravery. What the fuck? Okay. Okay, hold on, hold on, hold on. Shit, where is it? Where is it? Where is it? Where is it? Yo, where's that other mob? There it is. Nice. Nice. Screw douche. And another thing I've also noticed, I mean, at least in the dungeons that I've been in for World of Warcraft, I don't know if you guys have the ability to pull wall to wall. I think you do. I'm pretty sure you guys do. But I mean, dungeons in WoW, they feel a lot slower. I don't know if that's just, you know, because I guess in WoW, like, you guys have to kind of plan out your routes a little bit more, whereas Final Fantasy is more linear. But I really did notice that it feels like it takes longer. I don't know, maybe, how many bosses are there in dungeons for WoW? I think you guys have 4 per dungeon, 4 or 5. Healer. And there it is. He was still okay. I mean, he didn't take that much damage. Alright, guys. GG's. G freaking G's. Alright. Alright. Let's do story. Alright. Farshan. Man, it's been a minute, little homie. It has been a minute. How you been? Been taking care of yourself? That's good. Guys, welcome back. Welcome back. Currying flavor. Currying flavor. Huh. Washon's eyes lights up when he sees you. Actually, since it feels kind of casual, let me go Sage. Yeah, I like my outfit for Sage. I've been playing a lot more Sage, so. I mean, at least so shit pops off, then we're probably going to run something else. But, yeah. I wonder, do you guys have, like, little animations like this in WoW as well? Let me know. Alright. Ah, it's good to be back. Lord, it's good to see you. Have you any news from old Charlian? We've yet to hear from Yastola regarding her search for the means of returning to the void. I must confess that her silence has left me feeling restless. Nor that I am alone in this. Astinian has such an excess of energy that he's been helping to train our soldiers with nary a grumble. With nary a grumble. Good old Astinian. As for Zero. The fuck? Oh, there she is. Hey, Zero. We weren't talking about you. Is something the matter? No. Lord paid us a visit, and I was espising her of the recent developments, or the lack thereof. Are you heading somewhere? Aye, to replenish my ether. Cool. Bro, Zero has come such a long way in such a short amount of time. Would you like to come? Bro, a date with Zero? Hold on. What? Finally, this game has come full circle. Yes, I would like to come on you. I mean, yes, I would like to come. A real but welcome visitation. Timely too, I might add. I myself was thinking of venturing out into the city. It would be my pleasure to join you. Oh, she was asking for Sean. I mean, but I knew they were going to ask me regardless. So, you will accompany us, of course. Yeah. Of course. Come then. I have an errand to run at the bazaar first. Okay. Oh, it is good to be back, man. It's good to be home. It's good to be fucking home. Yep, we're definitely back at Final Fantasy. Alright. Okay, so we have to go to the bazaar. Let's see. Oh, and it feels good to like fast travel again. That way I can just pop around the map. Oh my god, that's... Oh. Dude, thank you for the etherites, Yoshi P. Thank you for these fucking etherites. Bro, I'm taking these etherites for granted, man. Just freaking riding everywhere in WoW. Hey, girl. I mean, it doesn't make the game feel vast, but my god. Is it a pain in the ass? Okay. I'm picking up some spice. Marad told me to do so before my next visit. Mr. Zero has quite the talents, you see. the sisters know we Harshon Harnish are fond of spicy food, but I doubt any of us could keep up with her. True. True. With just the spices they normally have on hand, the merchant couldn't quite satisfy her, which is why I'm happy to provide what they need to achieve more rigorous flavors. Now then, variety being the spice of life, perhaps you would like to choose something extra to blend with Mistress Zero's, you would like to choose something extra to blend with Mistress Zero's usual. I'll help keep things interesting. It'll help keep things interesting. What do you say? Fine by me. You can appreciate the nuance of this world's substance far better than I can. Okay, we're helping Zero pick out some spices. Ooh. Easy color for his spices. Appear for a happy sack. Okay. Let's go. Ooh, crimson powder. The little red husk. Coarse yellow flakes. I'm gonna go for the luscious crimson powder. Bright red in powders. It's hot. Yeah, I love hot food. Hot and spicy food, man. And plus, I don't think there's a wrong choice here. Ah, that's a fine choice. But don't take my word for it. Here, have a taste. Zero may wish to observe your reaction. It would be considered to sample the spice in her presence. Okay. Let's see, place of... Let me see, the eternity on your tongue. Eternal bleed engulfs your mouth. Your reaction speaks volumes. That will suffice then. Always a pleasure, Mistress Zero. And do give Marad my regards. Okay. Easy. Oh, actually. Let's go, monk, and then... Yeah. There we go. Since we're being kind of casual right now.
My usual, please. But with this spice. Of course, Cyril. It would be my pleasure. Well, now, this is enough to make a whole kettle of your special curry.
Bro, it's good to be home. I've missed this music.
I don't need that much. Rest assured, it's easy enough to make a serving just for you. Or we could make the kettle and share it. There would be enough not only for your companions, but other diners as well. I dare say everyone will be delighted.
Very well.
A full kettle, then.
Damn.
Excellent. We'll prepare it at once. And for your excellency and our esteemed adventurer, are you happy to try a bowl of Zero's curry? We can make yours milder if you prefer.
Grateful though I am for the offer, I cannot fully appreciate the flavor with this vessel. Another time, perhaps.
Do not
hold back on my account, my friend. Eat and enjoy.
Don't mind if I do. That shit looks good for real. Well, I bet it's gonna look good. Let me see. If I can have mine, I touch mine. Then I'll have His Excellency's healthy. Hell yeah.
understood. Please, make yourselves comfortable.
Dude, I think this is the first time that the three of us have sat down, just, you know. True.
Of course, spices also have the effect of preserving foods, which makes them highly coveted in foreign lands. All of this has given rise to a thriving spice industry, and the wealth it brings has allowed our nation to prosper while maintaining its neutrality.
So you trade your spices? Seems rather more complicated than trading in ether.
Not at all.
In the beginning, this land was no more than refuge for me. But now it is my home, and the people of Radzathan, my beloved children.
Nice, man. Bruh. Vitra's the homie. Vitra is definitely the homie.
Together, we build this vibrant nation. And naught would please me more than to show it to my sister one day.
Vibrant. Rubicante said the same when he described this world. A reminder of all that has been stolen from us. What many who remember doubtless yearn to take back.
Our home is a lost cause. Our only choice to begin anew. In this world, where we may reclaim our mortality.
That's tough.
Nonetheless, it's wrong to damn another to save yourself. As I told Rubicante, as I found myself moved to speak, I still do not understand what made me feel this way. Nor what compels you mortals to help one another. But I hope to someday.
Eventually she'll get there.
We too hope that you will find the answers you seek.
That was deep.
What is going on?
Oh shit. What's oh. They're just bringing us our food.
Mr. Zero, the Satrap's honored guest, we are serving a special curry for anyone who wishes to party.
Ooh.
But be warned, it is not for the faint of heart.
Bro, that shit looks good. Oh my god, that looks... Oh. You know, even though it's, you know, like, what do you have over there in India? Because, I mean, that's what Razadhan is inspired of. Well, inspired, you know, to be, like, in this game, India. Some kind of bread. Oh, not, ooh, that looks like chili.
Oh, by all means, I'd welcome the challenge.
Bro, that shit looks good. Woo! Look at the fire!
Sisters have mercy. The smell alone is...
Damn. Bro, look at him kick like a roach. Damn! Oh my god. Bro, I'm gonna tank this. Bro, I love moments like this, man.
I don't have time for that. I've been waiting for this.
Damn, bitch.
Let's replenish our ether.
Hey, alright, Zero, like, let's take it easy. Let's, you know, just, we're just eating. Ah, we didn't see the... Damn, they're dead. We killed half the citizens of Rosadon. My whole life flashed before my eyes. I see. Pick were perfect. It was a Yeah, the first one.
I trust you have eaten your fill.
Dude, we tanked that.
Prepare a meal for us to take to Estinian. I suspect he too is overdue a replenishment. By this hour, he will have retired to his chambers at Magaduta. Come, let us pay him a visit.
Ooh, the homie. Ooh, that looks like caramel, like some kind of caramel milk. That looks good. But yeah, let's see the homie Estinian, bro. Let's get the band back together. Damn! Damn! We killed them. We killed them. Alright. Man, there's moments like that, man, that really make Final Fantasy feel just special. Welcome back, Master Estinian. Yes, he's returned to his chambers. I shall be happy to escort you.
Estinian, are you there? We've brought something for you.
Probably asleep. Nope, he's awake. Okay. Bro, what the fuck? He's still going. Damn. Bro, I see you, Square Enix. I know. Bro, they did that. They did that for all the Estinian stands. All those stands. I know why they did that. Bro, you, the devs think they're slick. They think they're slick.
Masala, right? I prefer my squid dried, but I'm sure it won't disappoint. My thanks.
Well, I mean, you gotta stay in shape.
Idle as I am in our sorceress's absence, I see. I can't offer much in the way of entertainment, but make yourselves comfortable.
Bro, has Estinian always been this tall? Did he grow? Uh-oh. Bro. No. No fucking way. No fucking. What is this patch? What is this fucking patch? Yes. I think, well, just zero. I think zero should. Bro, what is this patch? What is this patch? We've just started, and it's already fire.
No, we simply caught our friend unprepared. Make himself presentable at once. I am sure.
Vashon, don't be a... Come on, man. Don't be a buzzkill, man. Come on. Don't deny me this right. Lame. We were close. Hey, Estola. And Orionji. Bro, it's been so fucking long. I've almost forgotten what they look like. My god, it's good to see you guys.
My friends, tell me, were you able to devise a way to return to the 13th?
I believe so.
Ooh.
It required a visit to the moon, where I took the opportunity to enlist Orionji's assistance.
Loperitz, let's fucking go. Oh yeah, Orionji wasn't He wasn't there for that.
If Rubicante spoke true, both Golbez and Ashdaya are on the moon of the 13th. Unlike here in the source, however, we have no means of making the journey from the surface of the star itself. The technology simply does not exist. Therefore, I propose that we employ a gate to deliver us directly to our destination.
Okay.
Is such a feat possible?
In theory, having once been a single hole, the source and its reflections share striking similarities in geography. And according to a certain someone who unceremoniously whisked us away to the first, the same locations across the world are intricately bound.
Yeah, girl. Good guy. He meant well.
All of which is to say, were we to pass through a gate on the source's moon, it should lead us to the moon of the 13th.
Ooh, oh yeah. Genius.
Of course, there is the risk of Void Scent gaining entry to our world. Thus did I decide to seek Orionge's counsel.
Both the Watcher and the Loperitz are aware of our proposed endeavor. While they are yet deliberating precautionary measures, they have pledged their full cooperation.
Okay. Easy.
You've been busy. I presume you've also found a way to open this gate.
Be it in Radzathan or Shalion, scholars have long cast their gaze onto the endless dark of the void. And so, with Harnish insights to augment our knowledge, we have indeed conceived of a promising plan to pierce the veil.
Nice. What is it?
A plan I am confident will succeed, precisely because the moon is our stage.
Hell yeah. Real, the determination, the ambition. I like it.
Extensive, and we will require vast quantities of ether.
I don't think we can use the Titans.
After all, our gate must be large enough to accommodate another great worm. My proposal entails delivering copious amounts of ether to the Tower of Babel in Garlemald. As you will recall, Fandaniel used the structure to destroy the brand's imprisoning Zodiac.
Right.
And we, in like manner, will use it to channel ether to the moon. I open our gate.
That can work.
Then we shall need someone on the moon for the necessary rituals.
Just so, Your Excellency. I intend to head back anon for that very purpose, as well as to help devise our strategy to deal with invading Void Scent. Along with our lunar allies, we will once again require the assistance of your alchemists, Nidana not least of all.
It's good to see her. It's going to be good to see her too.
I trouble you to serve as their escort.
Fine by me. The room was beginning to feel constraining.
Bro, he's always ready, bro.
For my part, I shall oversee the requisite tasks on the star. Might I prevail upon you for your assistance?
Oh, he was asking both of us? Oh, okay. All three of us. That's the plan.
All are in agreement. Then let us set to work.
Time to clock in, boys.
We'll open our gate, and we will stop Golbez.
They're very confident that it's going to be that easy. Holy. The Dark Throne. Holy. It's good to be back, bro. There it is. Guys, we are moving. It is time to head back. Well, that's the plan. That is the plan. And I love it when a plan comes together. Bro, we've come so far. In the next one, we talk with Orianji. And, let's see. Oh. Going ham? What the fuck? This is going to be the new dungeon. Let's fucking go. This is going to be so sick. I can't wait to play that. Okay. All right. Guys, I'm going to have to end it right here. I'm sure this is going to be way too long. But, I'll chop it up, make it, and keep as much in as I can. It's good. It is so damn good to be home. Take care. And bye-bye.